Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Oh. Be pleasant to them, and I shall rejoice in the Lord. Oh, that sinners would cease from Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Сажите нас пред Собой, а ви, Бог мой. salvation, the human race, look upon your servants and your inheritance, for you the awesome judge, who loves mankind, have your servants bow their heads and bend their necks, awaiting on help from men, but entreating your mercy and looking humbly for your salvation. Guard them at all times, who bring this present evening and approaching night from every enemy, from all adverse powers of the devil, from vain thoughts and evil matters. May the majesty of your kingdom be blessed and glorified in the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever unto the ages of ages.
Us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we
spasena.
Throughout history, we see
this struggle. But one thing we can truly stand to say is the aggressor, majority or completely, all of the time, has never been Ukraine. They've only ever been the defendant, defending their freedoms. Because again, fought to defend the freedoms of Ukraine. That's why they were known as the freedom fighters. And we continue. And this freedom is not only for Ukrainians. It's significant because we see a course of actions that is mirroring other times in history happening today. It's important that we come together and pray, that we come together, as we spoke outside, to petition our governments in whatever country we live in, here in Canada or other governments, to recognize that this is important. Sad fact is that at the fall of the Soviet Union, specifically three countries stepped forward to say, Ukraine, disarm yourself from the nuclear weapons that you held because of the Soviet Union, and we will back you, and will support you. Russia, Great Britain, and the United States. Sadly, they're not there. We are here. We can pray. We can give the assistance that we need to, and we have to. Praying to the Most Holy Theotokos, the Mother of God, for her protection. As she protected Kyiv many centuries ago, may she do it again, protecting the land. Those who are watching the news feeds in Kyiv, there's that pillar with the statue above. It's the Holy Archangel Michael, the patron saint, the protector of Kyiv and the Ukrainian land. As we also, the Holy Apostle Andrew, who on the hills of Kyiv proclaimed, this will be a great nation. These are not coincidences. The church has been something important in Ukraine for centuries. Its faith has been strong. And we share that faith and bring that into our hearts and share that prayer with those. So I thank you, and I encourage you, if you're wondering who to pray to, when to pray, pray whenever it feels you feel the desire. Who to pray to? To Christ, to the Mother of God, to the Holy Archangel Michael, to the Holy Apostle Andrew. These saints have been there and protected Ukraine throughout the centuries, and God willing, they will continue to protect and give them the strength. And give us the strength to continue to fight for what is right here, where we are. Again, thank you. I pray that you have a blessed evening. As I said outside earlier, we will be having specific services of prayer that will be scheduled in the coming week, and we will continue to have the prayer that we read today, as well as potentially other prayers for Ukraine and for the people as time goes by. Continue, please, to pray and to think about our brothers and sisters there. There is some of our service.
are here today in Vernon. You're always welcome to join us for any of those services if you wish to support us by bringing people through prayer here in our church. You're always welcome to join us. But thank you. I pray that you have a blessed evening. If you wish to join us tomorrow we have the Divine Liturgy begin at 10 a.m. here in the church. Christ is in our midst. Christos is in our midst.
Good luck.